You're the top U.S. diplomat here in Israel. Talk about what this position means to you personally. You're observant. You've spent a lot of time here in Israel before you became ambassador. Your daughter just made Aliyah, moved here to Israel. Talk about what holding this position means to you personally.
I have very few passions in my life, but I feel those passions intensely. One of my family, my wife, my children, my grandchildren. The other is really my love of my country, the United States, and my love for Israel. So here, after 35 years as a practicing lawyer, the president gave me this opportunity to represent the country of my birth, the country of my citizenship, the country that I love, in strengthening the relationship with the country of my faith. It is a dream come true. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I thank God every day that I wake up and I have this job.
Yeah, it's a perfect combination, and everything, your background, your close relationship with President Trump in previous years, absolutely prepared you for this position, Ambassador. Last question, what can Christians do for the U.S.-Israel relationship, I guess you would say? Why is it so important for Christians and Christians United for Israel, our organization, to stand with Israel, and also not just with Israel, but the Jewish people around the world in this time of increased anti-Semitism?
Well, Christians and Jews are partners in the Israeli enterprise. I don't know that, I mean, I've been amazed as I study the history of Israel, how many great Christians have contributed, whether it's Ord Wingate or Raoul Wallenberg or Oscar Schindler. So many have made lasting contributions to the state of Israel. They're entitled to participate in this Israeli enterprise along with the Jews, and they should. And I'm seeing more and more as part of this job how Christians are coming here. They're excited to be here. They are, you know, I've met with many of them from different states, different countries, and these are transformational experiences when they come here, and we welcome them all.
And this is the one place in the Middle East where they have true religious freedom in the state of Israel.
Not only do they have religious freedom, but I think the state of Israel will continue to do all it can to encourage Christian tourism, and the holy sites here are absolutely magnificent and inspiring.
Thank you, Ambassador.
Erick, thank you so much.
I appreciate
your coming.
Thanks a lot. Thanks again to Ambassador David Friedman for having us at his beautiful residence in Herzliya. He's a man of deep humility who recognizes his crucial position in these chaotic times in which we are living. As Americans, we are very fortunate to have a man like him in such an important role. Well, coming up after the break, you've heard the story of the Palestinian refugees, but there's another story you might not have heard about. The hundreds of thousands of Jewish refugees who were forced to flee their homes here in the Middle East not so long ago. Learn the story of the forgotten Jewish refugees after the break.